Sorting facility, yeah. It's garbage.
We were supposed to visit our biodiversity. Anyway, it will get
Inshallah,
better.
We'll come back.
Bye.
Elena.
Yeah. Thank you.
Bye. Take care. You know, overnight, we've seen more than 1 million people being displaced by the attacks, hostilities, by the aggression. And this is similar to an earthquake. You don't see this number in its scale and the speed of it, except in major natural disasters. And this is what happened in 48 hours. So as much as anyone could be prepared, and we were not prepared due to a lot of the challenges we have in the administration, in the multiple crises we've been going through for the last 4 years, as much as we tried with UN agencies, with non-governmental actors, no one could deal with a quarter of the population moving from their homes into another place. Minute by minute, so whenever we hear about these attacks coming, and then we see what's happening on the ground, and we start this. I think we should go a bit upstream, that still aid is minimal. It's not only about the distribution. I think the focus of distribution is definitely well noted, but we really need a lot of the aid. I think whatever we received so far, either bilaterally, and we're very grateful for all the Arab and other nations who have been helping us, or through the multilateral organizations, UN agencies, doesn't actually reach the 20% of the needs. To play a role.
I mean, that's the crazy part. There's only a couple of schools that are...
$250 million a month for a country that's actually annual budget doesn't exceed $2 billion. So this is the challenge, and the root cause of this is actually a war waged against us, a war that's totally not respecting any of the international humanitarian law or any of the UN resolutions or any of the international law. And I think this is what matters. We need to stop the war. We need to have a ceasefire today, and we need everybody in the international community for once to be brave enough to say what's happening, that there is a member state of the UN waging war against a small nation in the most aggressive manner we have ever seen in the history of Lebanon. This is what matters, and this should be the message.
Using whichever means available to make sure this information are reached to the community in order to...
And we issue daily, if you like, daily...
We're having a planning timeline for the next 4 to 6 months, including humanitarian and basic and social services. The message that this war has to stop. But secondly, if Lebanon fails, Lebanon has been hosting 1.5 million Syrian refugees that no one else wanted to have them. Europe, with all its might, and the global north, no one wanted to have the refugees. 25% of its population has been refugees for the last decade. And now we add another 25% of displaced Lebanese. This is the biggest displacement situation in the world. If this continues in this way, and this collapse altogether, the spillover will be to our neighboring countries, I mean Europe. It's billions of dollars of reconstruction, including houses, you know, full villages on the border were blown up in the last few days. But also public institutions, you know, water establishment, pumping station, hospitals, name it. All of these need to be rebuilt. But let's stop this war and we will rebuild them. I'm not worried about it, but we need to stop the war today. And I think this is again, the main message, if this stops today, we can think of reconstruction and getting people back to their homes.
I have 27 years in UNDP. So, unfortunately, what is happening in Lebanon, or is it UNDP before, for me, what is most important is that this to achieve. And on the personal level, the most challenging part has been to make sure that the... So I'm very concerned when it comes to situation of food systems and sustainability of the food security overall for the country. I'm not talking from the perspective of what is required in an immediate term in the next month. I'm talking about the impact that has on the harvesting season when it comes to all the growth value chains for the agro-food businesses, being it impacted in the south, being it impacted in the east, which are very, very important for the country.
هناك بعض الرأي على المحطوطين.